Hi everyone, hope you're doing well from whenever you're watching this channel, depending on your time zone. Now, there are suspects who have been arrested in Njoro for operating unregistered business. Now, these individuals registered a company to operate as a timber yard, supply timbers. That is what they registered for. But now, if you go and check the operations in that company, the property, it is total opposite that is taking place there. Now, what is happening is that there is operation to do with the seed making. These people are now focusing on treating the seed and selling it to the public. But now the big issue here is that they are now selling this seed in pretense. They are, in fact, it's a counterfeit because number one, they are using another company's name and a packaging, Kenya Seed Company. They don't have authority to use that. They don't have a permission. They are not in any partnership, but they are operating as Kenya Seed Company, but registered as a timber yard. That is the situation that we are in now as a country. So these individuals have been arrested with some maize that already been treated. I don't know which kind of treatment are they giving to that, because now even you look at what they are doing, it's total counterfeit. And this is the situation.
Ladies and gentlemen, our media persons, I want to welcome you. Here I'm with the Matingency team, the County Security Committee, the KELFIS, and the Kenya Seed Company for the purpose of an operation that we conducted yesterday after baada ya kupokea habari kutoka kwa wananchi ya kwamba wanashuku kuna seeds ambazo zinatengenezwa Njoro ambazo sio halisi. KELFI na Kenya Seed wakaja na DCI kufanya uchunguzi pale, wakaenda wakapata ya kwamba kuna kampuni iko hapo karibu Ngof Estate in Njoro ambayo iko licensed kama sehemu ya kuuza mbao. Baada ya kuingia pale, wakapata ya kwamba kuna seeds ambazo ziko nyuma yetu, ziko na the counterfeited, ziko na makaratasi ya Kenya Seeds ambayo ni genuine, na walipata 101 kg ya treated maize, which means ilikuwa tayari ikitoka iuziwe wakulima wetu. Alafu wakapata undressing seed machine, wakapata ngunia 18 ambazo zilikuwa untreated, mahindi ambayo ilikuwa inangojea tu kuwekwa ndawa na kupakiwa iuzwe, na wakapata stickers za Kenya Seeds which are counterfeit ambazo zilikuwa 34,780.
Now we are continuing this back in the discussion, but just a quick request for those who are watching and you have not yet subscribed, please consider subscribing. To our returning subscribers, I must say thank you so much. And again, to all our viewers, please give this video a thumbs up. Thank you so much, and back to this discussion. Now, we have been just talking about fake fertilizer in this country, where the government just decided that farmers will be supplied with the painted stones. You know, you're talking about donkey's poo and all that. Just paint, package, and with the government logo, sell it to the farmers. It happened. Today, it is good they have arrested these individuals because they are just taking maize without even considering the type of seed. No proper preparation that you are preparing a seed to sell to the people. And they're just painting it. Then sell it to the farmers, of which is not going to be the right seed. So you expect to harvest, you end up also losing. So we are not sure of their treatment to that maize and all that. Definitely, these guys have been exposing farmers to danger because it also affects your harvest. You buy an expensive seed. You know, let's say for 2 kg, they're selling 800. And if you go on the market, you find they just took normal maize at 100 shilling per gorogoro. That's 2 kg. Then they paint it and sell it at 800. Look at the kind of profit they make out of that. This is highway robbery. So let them face full force of the law for such kind of activity. Because now we don't know even where is their depot, where they sell it, because they prepare from here. Then from here, this product will find its way on the market. It will be on the shops. It will be in the agrovet. People will be selling this item. Some without knowing they're selling counterfeit. But then, how did the rain start beating us? This idea, it seems to have been originated from the Kenya Kwanza administration. It was discovered because a journalist and a media decided to do an investigation, not the government. And it seems like they are exposing the government. Look at that. So it's a behavior now Kenyans are learning from the UDA administration. So it's not far from what UDA is doing. Therefore, we will blame UDA administration for all this kind of mess. Because what Kenyans are doing, they're just copy, pasting from what the government is doing, and they just practice exactly the same thing. So as you arrest them, tell us, when are you going to arrest Mithika Linturi, CS for agriculture? The man who has come out so furiously to demonize people like Alan Nam, who have done a good job in defense of the fertilizer, who exposed Kenyan farmers to a danger by supplying painted soil in the name of fertilizer. So when are they going to arrest Mithika Linturi? They should be coming to tell us that. As long as they're not going to arrest Mithika Linturi, they are still providing an opportunity to have such kind of behavior to continue in this country. So all this, we are going to put a blame in this administration because it can never happen that NCPB, which is a government property, has been used to supply huge amount of fake fertilizer to farmers. Then we have used that one to do our plantation. And we are expecting to, you know, lose a lot. So, as police officers are explaining what happened in Jor, as they link those suspects to these counterfeit products, let them also tell us who supplied the fake fertilizer to NCPB, and who gave the tender, and who are the beneficiaries. The government will nail down these people if they want to do so. Because even the transaction that were happening, it wasn't cash. People were getting messages on their phone. You get to NCPB, you show your message, and you pay, then you are given your mzigo. You go back home. So this man was not given cash. It is very easy to trust these individuals. They have receipts from NCPB with a rubber stamp. So we will not celebrate what they have done today. We are waiting to see them arresting those big fish. This one is a small one, and he's doing so because he has learned that this is the behavior of UDA and the Kenya Kwanza administration, that they walk scot-free after committing that such kind of economic crime in this country. Because you are sabotaging economy, we will have problem with the food security, we will be insecure. We are being endangered. People are going to lose a lot. Kuna watu wamejiajiri kwa ukulima and all many other ways. But when you do like this, you have endangered these people, they are going to lose in a big way. So, as long as the government will not compensate farmers, return their money, those who have tilled the land, planted, you pay all this and the damages. There was an expectation that when I plant like this, at this, you know, the size of land, the amount of harvest anticipated should be compensated. As long as they're not doing so, then they are encouraging Kenyans of bad behavior to continue with this kind of practice. So, it is the government that initiated this behavior. And now other people are copying, taking it to another level. We were going to live 5 years of disaster because we have been introduced and exposed to counterfeits. Mbolea, counterfeits. You come to seeds, counterfeits. You come to anything they give us, it's counterfeits.